What's going on, everyone? It's Mike from the Hardcover Comic here. Welcome to 2021. It's really nice to see you with us here still. Hope everyone's doing well, staying safe and sound. Today, I'm going to go through one of the things I've been doing for the past few months is just rereading books in my bookshelf. Obviously, I've got a lot of books. I've got over 300 of them. I've read all of them at least once, and I've sort of worked my way through rereading ones that I haven't read in a while or ones that I've been craving to read. If it catches my eye, I just dive right into it. So that's what I'm going to talk about today. I'm going to talk about iZombie. I'm going to talk about The Omnibus specifically. This was a title that came out of Vertigo Comics. There's a TV show based off of the comic book that I'm going to be talking about. Before we dive in, be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. This is what we do on a regular basis. We got live streams, overviews, hauls, top tens, custom binds, all sorts of crazy stuff happening. We're going to be trying to get interviews this year with creators, writers, artists, fun folks like that. But we also do have a Patreon where you get early access to these videos if you're interested. We also do giveaways. At the end of every month, you have the opportunity to win an Omnibus, Absolute Edition, Deluxe Editions, whatever it is that you feel like getting, a new release, old release, whatever it may be. We feel very generous most of the time. So a lot of fun stuff happening there. If you're interested in dust jackets, merch, all that, check out our email down in the description below. Hit us up if you want to just chat, if you just want to talk about something, that's cool too. That's what we're here for. We love chatting with you all. Let's dive into some iZombie. Looking at the actual omnibus here, this was kind of a blind buy for me. I really like Mike Allred, and that's why I picked it up. It's got this cool kind of matte gloss finish, sort of the background's matte, but then the actual characters are glossy. It's really nice. It's actually a nicely designed book, of course, with Mike Allred artwork wrapping all the way around it. It collects the entire series, and you know, it wasn't very expensive when it came out either. underneath the dust jacket, you've pretty much got the exact same thing. And like I said, iZombie, complete blind buy for me. It's written by Chris Robertson with artwork mostly by Mike Allred. There are some other artists that jump in and do an issue here or there, or a few pages of an issue here or there. I'm looking, you know, at a pretty good sized story here. And of course, it's all contained in its own universe. It's its own thing. And I personally really liked it. It deals with supernatural things without getting very, very serious about it. And it sort of deals with different aspects of the supernatural world. Like, how would these characters interact with regular people on a daily basis? If this was all happening in some small town somewhere, there are fun twists to everything. Like, you know, there are different kinds of zombies, there are different kinds of ghosts, and they do this, they have this really interesting explanation, Chris Robertson and Mike Allred, where they talk about the oversoul and the undersoul, and how various states of those two kinds of souls will dictate what you sort of become after passing, and how that's affected by the way in which you died, whatever it may be, right? There's all these different factors that go into it. Not only are you dealing with zombies, but you've got vampires, you've got werewolves, you've got vamp monster hunters, you've got mummies. It's crazy. There's all sorts of different characters in here, all very supernatural, all very fun. And Mike Allred's artwork, while, you know, on a more serious title involving monsters like this, may not have been my favorite choice. On a title like this, where it's a little lighter, it's not as serious and intense as like a title like Witches or something, It works really, really well, because Mike Allred, you know, with Laura Allred doing coloring, it's very vibrant, it's very, it brings the tone up a little bit from like a super serious tone to a more lighthearted one. And like I said, I really liked seeing the character interaction and seeing how all these weird characters pop up to begin with, like who was the first zombie, how did all this happen, where did this monster hunting group come from? There's all sorts of universe exploration in this, thankfully, and you get to see a lot of characters expand as characters themselves, but you get to see their relationships with other people and how that changes them, what happens to those other people as a result, how they get tied into the entire story here. And what's really even more crazy about this story is, like, despite all this stuff that's happening, the ending actually deals with something completely crazy that you have no idea is coming. Well, you do, but you find out like in that last story arc what's happening. Everything's been building up to this insane moment. It's really well done. I must say it's really well done. Again, a book I had zero expectations going into. Mike Allred's artwork was the only motivation I had to check this out, and I really enjoyed it. The omnibus itself, in terms of a reading experience, you do have to hold it a little bit. Doesn't stay flat from the first few pages. It takes a couple hundred pages even for it to lay flat. But it's okay. It's okay because it's not a crazy expensive omnibus. And in terms of the build, the paper's really nice. You do get a little bit of gutter loss, but there aren't too many two-page spreads. Here you can see some of the other artwork that was in there aside from Mike Allred's, where you're sort of getting the history of this Monster Hunter group and various other characters. One thing I will say is the main character, we'll take a look at the spine here. One thing I will say is the main character, when she eats brains, she actually gets the memories of those people, and she feels a need to fulfill that person's whatever dying wishes or whatever it may be. Here we got just a little bit of bonus content, mostly a lot of artwork by Mike Allred. So if you're into that sort of thing, it's very cool. There's not too much of it, but a decent amount, good enough. But I really liked iZombie. It's a book that, again, I read it the first time and I wasn't sure if I'd want to keep it. Read it the second time, I was like, this is fun. It's a nice change of pace. It spices things up a little bit. It's different, and it stands out on the shelf. It's a interesting looking book because of the Mike Allred design. I love Mike Allred, so I'm a big fan of this book now. Big fan. So what do you think? Would you read iZombie? Have you read iZombie? What did you think of iZombie? iZombie? Too much iZombie? iZombie. let us know down in the comments below, seriously, what you thought of iZombie. If you have read it, if you haven't, did I get you interested? Might you check it out? It's a good book, I promise. I really enjoy it. Otherwise, I wouldn't have it on my shelf and I wouldn't be rereading it as much as I have. Check out our Patreon if you guys are interested in winning hardcover comic giveaways, Omnis, Absolutes, a bunch of stuff. We do also put up our YouTube videos early there, so you get early access to them days before they're on the actual YouTube page. And subscribe if you haven't already, guys. This is what we do on a regular basis. Check in, talk about new books we've received, upcoming hauls, custom binds, whatever's happening in the THC universe. Live streams are really becoming a lot of fun now, getting real crazy. So can't wait to see what happens with those. Thank you all very much for tuning in. This is Mike from the Hardcover Comic. Until next time, as always, you stay classy, Internet.